instructor Captain Molina, but you can just call me Jess. This session, we'll get started with some basic intro. First things first, let's get familiar with your surroundings. Don't worry. I've got the stick while you get your bearings. Out your side windows, you can see we have great visibility over Sedona today. This is Red Rock territory. Beautiful, isn't it? Expected, with a nose-down attitude, our altitude is decreasing, while our speed is picking up. Why don't you get us back to a cruise attitude, and we'll hit the last part of our lesson. There we go. Now that we know how to cruise, climb, and descend, let's talk about the turn attitude. Gently pull the yoke left or right to start rolling the plane. If you take a look outside, you can see how our attitude's changed, but you can also check your instruments for the details. As a general rule, you always want to keep your turns under 30 degrees. At the top of your attitude indicator, there's a series of notches representing 10 degrees each. Use them to control your roll. Notice the more you turn, the more you need to pull back on the yoke to maintain altitude. When you're rolling out, you'll need to do the opposite. Roll and push at the same time. The more you know about the main attitude, I've got control now. Well done. Use your rudders to stay on the center line and keep pushing power until you reach 55 knots. Good. Now gently pull back on the yoke. Line up the top of your instrument panel so it's a couple inches above the horizon. That'll pitch us up and set a good climb attitude. And we're airborne. Focus on flying straight. Use your rudders to keep the runway heading of 210 degrees. Maintain 75 knots, and we'll reach our target altitude of 5,500 feet in no time. Lesson. Straight and level flight. First step here is adjust.